respected President, Comrade Hemalata, also the President of CITU, Comrade Michael, the President of the WFTU, Comrade Tappenson, General Secretary CITU, Comrade Soundar Rajan, Chairperson of the Reception Committee, Comrade Sukumaran, that State Secretary of the CITU, esteemed leaders of the fraternal national centers, functionaries of CITU, my dear comrades, brothers and sisters, I am present here to convey the fraternal greetings and solidarity of lakhs of members of the Hindma Sur Sabha. I also congratulate the leadership of CITU, the past and the present, for vigorously struggling for the benefits of the workers in this country. Comrades, we are meeting when there is a huge challenge before the trade union movement. The economy is in a free fall. It has been declining for a long, consistently. But the Bharatiya Baniya Party at the center does not recognize the fact that there is an economic slowdown. The Prime Minister of this country, whenever he is available in India, recalls that he will make, proclaims himself that he will make India as a $5 trillion economy. But the harsh fact remains, even according to the chief economist of the IMF, Indian economy is going down. It's not only going down, it is also pulling down the world economy. This is the situation in this country. But the Modi government is arrogantly pursuing the destructive economic policies which suits their corporate masters, thereby paving way for greater inequality. The fascist government, instead of fulfilling our just demands, are encouraging the corporates and the multinationals to exploit our labor and national resources. Crores and crores of workers are growing poorer and poorer year after year. Even after 73 years of independence, successive governments could not ensure a minimum wage where a person can lead a dignified human life. Our wages do not keep pace with the soaring prices. The permanent jobs are converted into informal jobs. The hard-won labor laws through years of struggles are codified to favor the corporate masters in an autocratic manner without consulting us. The unemployment is soaring. It is now at 7.8%, which is 45 years high. And every 1 hour, sadly, one unemployed person commits suicide in India. The government is aggressively privatizing the public sector undertakings, the railways, defense, oil PSUs, airports, and allowing complete ownership in strategic sectors in spite of our strong resistance. In such a gloomy atmosphere, the only positive outcome in the last decade is our national trade unions have forged unity against anti-poor, anti-labor policies of Modi government. 8th of January, the country witnessed the culmination of anger by 25 crore workers of this country who participated in the national strike. Comrades, while we are busy fighting the anti-labor, anti-poor policies of Modi government, the government is busy in implementing the Hindutva agenda. To divert the attention of the people from the present crisis, the government is creating a divide by discriminating people on religious grounds. This is evident from the fact Modi and Shah are tinkering with the constitution and busy implementing the draconian CAA by imposing religious criteria. The government is using the brutal police force and the outfits of Sangh Parivar against the peaceful protests by students and large sections of the society throughout the country. The need of the hour is to further strengthen the unity of the working class. The unity we forge at the national and state level should also percolate down the line. I am sure this conference will discuss and deliberate the challenges before the workers, and confident you will come up with an action plan to overcome the challenges. I wish the Congress a great success. Long live trade union unity.